Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers, welcome back. In today's video, I'm showing you how to associate your fragrance with your moon, or at least showing you my personal routine. Enjoy the video. Good morning. Oh, well, I'm very tired, or in the evening, or when I just wake up, just like right now. Oh, by the way, I'm crying from one eye. That's usually happen every morning. I'm just crying from one eye. So the usual fragrance I'm spraying in the morning at the moment is called Tea Tonic. And this is from Mila Harris. And it is so relaxing. In the morning, it smells like a fresh tea, like a fruity, juicy, fresh tea. It's slightly very zesty at the beginning, so you can really smell that zest and really dry down to something just very calming. But basically, it's just like you're having a lemon tea in the morning, I would say. So it's very energizing, but also very calming because I need to be in good condition to go to bed or to just wake up. But usually this is the one when I wake up, because I need a little coffee or tea. I'm spraying now and I feel very energized, and that's it. And then after, that's all. I'm going back to bed. Really brings also that luminosity in the morning, even if it's like not a really great weather. Like you have like this ray of sunshine with the zesty note that is very powerful at the beginning, and then it's so soothing. But yeah, it smells natural-like as well, very natural, and I feel I don't need something synthetic in the morning. I want to go all natural, all light and tonic. Right, so when I'm upset like this, and especially when I can't choose my clothes in the morning, it drives me insane. So usually what I'm doing at this moment is I will spray something that's gonna go with my awful mood, and that would be probably Lève Rouge. This is like a very like tough, strong leather notes with a touch of raspberry inside, so slightly fruity fragrance, but it's got that strong dark character that will suit probably like my dark mood of the day. And there's another one that will be completely different. It's really my happy mood fragrance, Jasmine Sambac and Marigold. So I could choose that to calm me down, but usually when I'm like that, I just want to stick to me being upset all day, and this is like this. I love this scent, just because it's got a little bit of green undertone and slightly musky leather notes. If you love Tuscan leather from Tom Ford, you're gonna absolutely enjoy that. This is the new baby in Mila Harris, and it's got that fruity note at the beginning that's pretty sharp, but when it dries down, it goes away, it faded and goes to that leathery, powdery leather, very dark, intense leather. So if you love that Tuscan leather, I really recommend it to try this one. I really enjoy it, but it's not like for a shy person. It's a pretty, pretty tough scent, and that's why I was thinking like for the days that are a bit more difficult, or you know, when I want to feel sexy as well. But you know, I quite like to wear something like quite strong when I'm in this kind of mood. I just want to follow that vibe. I should completely like get something relaxing, but I just get Lève Rouge. So what teaches to be confident? There's some days that we are missing confidence. You don't feel great. You didn't have a good day, and everything goes wrong technically. And you need a boost of something. You need something to clear your mind and to give you that boost. Yes, come on, do it. You're great. You're gonna do great today. So let's show that to everyone. But personally, my scent for confidence always been my signature scent. And you know, it's difficult for, I think, fragrance reviewer to have a signature scent, but I do have one, because if I would just live with one fragrance, I could. It would be number 22 from Chanel. So you can see the juice is very dark at the moment, just because when this fragrance takes a bit the light, it goes very dark quickly, but the juice is even better after. It smells very much more intense in the soapy cleanliness, which I think is beautiful. So this smells like bubble of champagne. It smells like something that is very fizzy, effervescent, very clean. Also, tuberose is so intoxicating, but it's not the tuberose that we can see nowadays, very creamy, sweet tuberose. No. It's a tuberose that is very opulent, slightly herbaceous, and greener, and it's so opulent, it's so strong. Number 22 is another interpretation of the classic timeless number 5. It was created 1 year after, so in 1922, and it was just like, I think, a beautiful interpretation of number 5. It's for the daring lady that wants even more than confidence in the bottle, and when you wear that, you just feel you could do anything. And I only wear it in special occasion, and especially when I have a very big day or I need to talk in public, then I will spray this. And there's another fragrance really recently that I sprayed, and this is a masculine scent, but I think for me it's very unisex. This is Grand Soir by Maison Cardichon. So this one is also one of my favorite at the moment, like since I discovered it, I just can't live without it. It's like a very ambery type of scent, and this amber is so rich, so intense, so deep, and when you smell it, for me it smells like pure luxurious, because it's not overpowering in sweetness, it's slightly balanced with a bit that woody type of tone, and I just think it's so beautiful. Once you smell that, if I have to choose one scent from MFK, that would be definitely this one. And this brings so much confidence. I like to wear something a bit more masculine myself to bring myself confidence, because especially when you have to stand in front of men as a lady, sometimes it's difficult. So I feel you need a bit of a boost. And this is when someone goes around you and smells this, like, this smells character. Oh, look at this man, look at this lady. She probably, or he probably, has a lot of, like, I don't know, taste and you know, character. I don't know, that's for me the scent of confidence. Anyway, usually when I feel a bit more creative, and it's usually when I'm in a really good mood and I want to create something, and I don't know, I want to do something different, I will go through one of my sample box and I will choose my scent out of my comfort zone. Meaning, I don't want to try something in my collection because I want something different. And I'm bored of everything usually when I'm creative, and I'm like, I need new fragrance, blah, blah, blah. So I will take my fragrance sample box and I will just pick one, and or pick few, I don't know, but see like which, you know, to just randomly try something, see how it lasts on me, see how it develops, and that's how I discover new scent, and I, you know, but yeah. So let's see. Is Replica Wicked Love. Oh, I'm so happy, I love this. Ah. Oh God. So this is a Replica Maison Margiela, and it's called Wicked Love. So if you don't know this scent, it's really like it's more like a floral, herbal, nearly garden-like scent. It feels a bit like a narcotic, like a poison. So you've got these kind of geranium accord. I don't know if this geranium, I will put the notes in there, but it smells very green. intoxicating and slightly rosy geranium, like minty touch of mint, but it's really like a fresh garden, but it's got a dry down that is very sweet, and I love this scent. It really feels wicked. It feels like something bewitching, and you smell right at the beginning this overpowering of green mintiness that is so fantastic. I think that would be one of the next purchases I will buy from Maison Margiela, because it's so nice, and I've tried it a few times on my skin now, and it does stay so long, so I'm always like very pleased with this one. And it's very strange, like if you don't like very green scent, you're probably not gonna enjoy that much, but for me it's got a touch of spiciness as well. Beautiful. Let's try another one. This is Amiris for Men by Maison Francis Cœur de Jean. Oh, let's spray a bit over here. Oh. Oh, God. Oh, this is so nice. Oh. Call me drama queen, but it's so beautiful. Smells a bit spicy, nearly like food-like, like you're gonna eat it. There's this barbershop scent, quite green at the dry down as well, that makes me think of very like masculine scent. The sweetness and the tone, floral. It's nearly like cumin, like you want really to eat it. It's very special. I never smelled something like that before. It's definitely more like spicy, but it's got like a touch of sweetness, and you can really smell a lot of masculinity without being too much. Charlie, mais qu'est-ce que tu fais? There's something very sharp in the fragrance. It smells like food to me. I really enjoy it, but I really enjoy the opening a lot, and then in the dry down, I'm not too sure anymore. The dry down feels a bit more spicier, so it's very special. I need to try it more. But I really enjoy the opening of it. It's not for me to say you love. Do you have a fragrance you use only when you're working or when you focus? Probably if you were in your office, that would be probably like an office kind of scent. You know, like a non-offensive one. For me, like that would be like a light version of number 5 if I was working or stuff like that. But like, as we're home now, we have to focus home. Like, it doesn't really matter if you offend other people, really, because that's just you or your family. So it's fine. So I've got personally a fragrance to be focused at the moment. It's like a, I would say it's still quite a strong fragrance, but it's like non really invasive, and I really enjoy it, and it's this one. So this is called Ebony Wood by Zara, and it's the collection that Jo Loves and Zara created together. So Jo Loves, Jo Malone. It's a really, I would say it's the most strongest scent of this collection, but it's really like, smells very like woody, but rich, a rich wood, you know. But it still is quite like brightening the day, I would say. There's something always brightening, it's not like completely strong. But yeah, so it smells a bit more woody, but it's a rich woody, a bit sugar woody, not too sweet. It's definitely unisex. If you like something like a bit like slightly intoxicating but smart scent, this is really what it makes me think of. When I spray it, it makes me think of something quite smart, and there's also an opening that is slightly fruity and juicy, so it's really like a nice and different fragrance, I would say, for the day. So this is what I'm wearing at the moment, and I absolutely love this scent. Also a scent that is like very, I don't know, it's very comforting. So when I'm focused working, I need something to keep me going, and smelling my fragrance while I'm working is really relaxing for me. So I need something that not too strong but still quite opulent to make me
want to go through the day. So yeah, if you ever like try this collection, you need to try. It's available on the website of Zara. It's like £12 something. It's really good. But yeah, if you like a sweeter fragrance with a touch of wood, it's so lovely. And I would say for daytime, it's beautiful. Obviously, like it's maybe a bit sharp to wear like on a very sunny day, but when it's a bit grey, I think it's beautiful and you get still that opening quite fresh anyway. So yeah, it's such a nice scent. So for me, the fragrance I use, it's bad. But you know, like I think fragrance can help you to feel a bit confident, like I said before, but also give you a bit that sensual, sexy vibe. And for me at the moment, so there's two fragrances I'm gonna say, one more masculine, one a bit more feminine, you know, for everyone. For me, the feminine one and the most sexiest I smell in months for ladies is Sappho. This is from Lush. This is one of their newest creation, and oh jeez, this smells like a jasmine that is creamy but very dirty at the same time. This smells a bit sexual. I don't know how to explain it another way, but it does really smell a bit sexual, a bit animalic, primitive tone. And the story of it is like I think Sappho, story around Sappho that is really hot, you know. So I invite you to have a look through this fragrance to discover the story. Basically, I think she was like, you know, she was a lesbian and she was really open-minded. Makes me think also of a boudoir, you know, like a boudoir is like a little room you had in the castle or during the Renaissance, you know. And the ladies were using it to have some different activity, but usually it was to meet their lover, not their husband, but the lover, over there in the boudoir and do some, you know. But it really gives me that tone. It's very cozy, but it does smell a bit animalic. And it's a jasmine that is very powerful, a bit dirty, like I said, and there's a touch of greenness. And Lush fragrances before, I mean, I've got a few of those, but Sappho, oh my god, it's my favorite. It's so sexy, so sensual. It smells also a bit like an old book. There's something very vintage-y, which I really enjoy, like it makes it even more special. So yeah, that's my sensual scent for ladies. Also, for men, if I would have to choose like a very sexy scent, a bit, you know, I would definitely go, at the moment I'm really into it, it's like Initial, it's Oud for Greatness. So I've talked about it in my 10 sexy fragrance, but wow, explosion of oud, even though it's not like this very animalic oud, it's got that slightly sugar tone, which remove all this usually too much animalic tone of oud. This is, oh my god, it's so pleasant. It's really like a bomb, like it's very overpowering. Once you smell it, everybody can follow you. And I just enjoy this scent so much. And I think it would be beautiful on anyone. It's just, you know, like it's got a touch of sugar tone that you can feel in Baccarat Rouge, but not that much. It feels like a very dry wood with a very smooth aspect, but once you spray it, it's projecting so much. And it's such a good name for it, Oud for Greatness. It's such a good name. It's really appropriate to it. So that's my flirty fragrances. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the video, and tell me, what's your personal routine? Do you associate your fragrance with your mood? What is your favorite combo, whatever? And leave me a little comment to explain that to me. Also, if you like the video and if you like the content, you want to see a bit more, you can subscribe to my channel, leave me a little like, and of course activate the little bell, because at the moment I don't know when I'm posting video. I'm a bit like, you know, I think everyone's routine is different now, so yeah.
So yeah, just activate the little bell because I don't know what I'm posting. But yeah, also, if you want to see a bit more on a daily basis, you can follow me on Instagram. I post every day, I try. And that's it really. I see you soon. Bye now.